Good morning and God bless you. We're delighted to have you with us here this morning. Maybe this is your first time tuning in and joining us. We extend a warm welcome to you and trust that you are blessed with what you hear today. We want to begin with prayer. We want to continue to pray for the direction of this nation. We want to pray for our local community and region. We want to remember Cornerstone Pentecostal Church. And lastly, our brothers and sisters around the world. Maybe you have a special unspoken request. It's a perfect time to make that known unto God. Let's pray together now. Father, we love you, we praise you, and we worship you. We thank you for the abundance of all things. Father, we pray for the direction of this country. We pray for the influence of the Word of God, the Spirit of God, and the Church of the Living God upon the direction of this great nation. We also pray for our local community and region and pray that you will continue to open up doors of utterance. We also pray for Cornerstone Pentecostal Church. We pray for the windows of heaven to be opened up over this congregation. And lastly, our brothers and sisters around the world, that you supply them with a hedge of protection. We ask all this in the name above every name, the name of Jesus Christ. Everybody said amen. Very quickly, Book of Psalms 32. Psalm 32, beginning in verse number 1. Blessed is he whose transgression is forgiven, whose sin is covered. Blessed is the man unto whom the Lord imputeth not iniquity, and in whose spirit there is no guile. This is what I want to talk about here, the next couple verses. When I kept silence, my bones waxed old through my roaring all the day long. For day and night thy hand was heavy upon me. My moisture is turned into the drought of summer. Selah. I acknowledged my sin unto thee, and mine iniquity have I not hid. I said, I will confess my transgressions unto the Lord, and thou forgavest the iniquity of my sin. Selah. Be sure your sins will find you out. Be sure your sins or sin will find you out. Now that is actually a verse of scripture that is found in the book of Numbers, but I didn't want to read that scripture and then not read this portion of scripture. I thought, you know what, this scripture in Psalm 32 is so critical to the overall process. Of course, David, the great psalmist, a man after God's own heart, blessed is he whose transgression is forgiven, whose sin is covered. But that is not how the story really begins. That's the end. That's when we go to God. That's when we confess. That's when we repent. But he made this statement. He said, when I kept silence, he begins to talk about part of the dilemma of keeping a sin unto yourself. You know, sometimes, well, let me say this. There is a difference with confessing and repenting and getting caught. Nobody escapes the inner judgment that comes within an individual when sin is carried out and continued to be carried out. David is saying here, when I kept silent, and he talks about this internal, he even refers to his bones. There's an internal chaos. There is a upheaval. There is a writhing. There is a the conscience of an individual and the heart of an individual and the mind of an individual is wanting to bring judgment and rectitude and to get right and to be right. But David described this incredible process in Romans chapter number 7. Oh, wretched man that I am, who shall deliver me from this body of death? So when an individual repents, blessed is the man whose transgression is forgiven. But when somebody is caught, there's a different process. There is a different process that is brought to the table, that is brought to the place of not just inner judgment, but getting everything in order and getting everything right. And I'm not here to say that a person cannot be forgiven and a person cannot be covered and a person cannot find relief and a person cannot find release. But there's a different starting point. The starting point is when there is sin, that there is, David is describing this inner upheaval, this inner clash of not just not being right, not feeling right, not being where I should be. But he also made this statement. I acknowledged my sin unto thee, and mine iniquity have I not hid. I said, I will confess my transgressions unto the Lord, and thou forgavest the iniquity of my sin. Confession and repentance is the quickest way to find restoration of relationship with God and relief from our conscience that will not let us back up. Our heart that will not let us rest. There is like a fomenting of the roaring of the waves. There just is no rest. The Bible said there is no rest to the wicked. And when there is behavior or thoughts or words or actions or something that I'm engaging in or something that I have done or whatever the situation may be, until I come to that place of acknowledging my sin, there will not be rest. And make no mistake about it, ladies and gentlemen, be sure your sins will find you out. That doesn't mean that somehow we are disengaged from reality. That means that reality goes to work. We just choose not to listen to it. And everybody said, amen. I have, I've been doing this for a little while now. And oftentimes I have found that when people are caught, that there is a different process that goes into effect to bring them to this place. As long as they get here, all of us need to get there. When there is sin, there needs to be repentance so that there can be restoration and there can be restitution and we can become right with God and go through the godly processes so that we can enjoy that restored relationship with God, with ourselves and with others. But until we're willing to put up the deceit, the self-deception, lying, whatever the case may be, facade, smokescreen, wearing a mask, whatever it is, there is not going to be rest. Listen to this. Listen to one of the greatest men I know is David. when he said, when I kept silence, my bones waxed old through my roaring. The roaring, this inner, the tempest of the rising of the waves of my conscience, and then the falling back down into suppressing that, suppressing my conscience, suppressing the truth, and suppressing reality. For day and night, thy hand was heavy upon me. My moisture is turned into the drought of summer. Selah. He's talking about the processes of feeling condemnation and feeling even conviction. Thy hand was sore against me. Just knowing what the truth is, knowing what is right and not making it right. Not making it right. To be found out by your behaviors, to be found out by your sin, to be found out, to finally face yourself is actually a glorious thing. Because it is the beginning of repentance and restoration of our relationship with God, our relationship with ourselves, and our relationship with others. There is no escape, ladies and gentlemen. I'm glad for that. We should be thankful for that. To suppress that, to try to rid ourselves from that process is what the Bible calls reprobation, to completely silence conviction, to quench the Holy Ghost, to resist the conviction, to act like it's not there, to try to outrun it, to try to silence it through drugs, alcohol, or just more illicit behavior, whatever the situation is a huge mistake. Blessed is the man whose transgression is forgiven and whose sin is covered. Your sins will find you out. They're breathing right behind you. You can hear the hounds of your conscience and your conscious mind trying to bring you back to a place of restoration and rightness. That's where health is. That's where beauty is. That's where joy is. That's where purpose is. That's where life is. That's where blessing is. You said, well, I feel miserable because I made this mistake. Get over it. God already knew that you were capable of making that mistake. All of us are capable of making that mistake. The Apostle Paul said, if not for the grace of God, except for the grace of God, there go I. He had the full awareness of what he was capable of doing. Ladies and gentlemen, it scares me to death of what I am capable of doing without the grace of God, without the conviction of the Holy Ghost, without the love of God, without my passion for God, without loving God, loving myself, loving the things of God, loving my family, loving my wife, da 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 da. All these things are a check and a balance. Be sure your sins will find you out. And when they find you out, just be like David. You know what? All right, I give up. I acknowledge my sin. Let's get it done. Let's get it over with. Let's get right. God bless you. Thank you for joining us here today. We'll look forward to seeing you here tomorrow.